you have old curse. First of all, I'd like to say that I felt that Long Branch fireworks were nice job, and that I commend the fire, the police, the EMT, and all the emergency workers that night with controlling that region of the crowd. Speaking on the beach access and Cobra Blue, I had to read you a little bit of what my feelings were with this. You're aware of the extreme that there is, excuse me, as you are aware, there is an extensive body of federal and state law collectively referred to as the public trust doctrine that holds that all the people own and have a right to use the beach without interference from anyone to the high mean waterline. The law in this area is a little blurred these days because now we have millions of citizens, federal tax dollars, which have artificially and temporarily moved the shoreline, the mean high water line, out hundreds of yards. It is generally accepted that the Army Corps, the DEP, and the courts view the water line before the replenishment sand is added as to where the mean high water line is for purposes of the public trust doctrine. Otherwise stated, this newly added sand paid for by the taxpayers is equally available for use by the taxpayers without interference. Separate from the right to use the beach under the public trust doctrine is the separate but related right of the access to the beaches. And I know I've discussed this in the past with the free public access areas. If we cannot actually get onto the beaches, if we cannot gain access to the beaches, then we cannot use them. This is not a complicated concept. From the border of Monmouth Beach on south throughout the city, there was no issue gaining access to the beaches. Indeed, recently the county moved the open gate in the south end of the Seven Presidents Park. Monmouth County was aware of their legal obligations simply and did this on their own. No one had to go to a freeholder meeting and complain to get action or to protect their rights. Even between the high rises in the area of the Ocean Cove and the Anchorage, there is reasonable access. However, once you go south past Afanasi Lake into the Elberon section, the homeowners act as if they own and have private beaches. Sunbathers, swimmers, surfers, fishermen, and just people who want to go for a walk on the beach have hurdle after hurdle, no adequate parking. The curbing is horrible at Afanasi. The street ends at Plaza and Pullman. No adequate parking, locked access points with privately constructed fences and signs that falsely advertise that the areas are private property. The problems near Kushner's property persist. But now the Garfield Court terrace area has become absurd. Fences have been constructed and signs put up to discourage and prevent access. Property owners are demanding that the citizens accessing the beach sign actual written waivers of liability.
Mr. Brock, excuse me, you have 1 minute.
Thank you. Actual legal documents demanding other information, none of which is allowed. So I'm asking the city to intervene and to have the fence removed and to advise the residents that they have no right to interfere with others accessing the beach. I am asking that the city take measures to create access points at the end of every street end and pass an ordinance guaranteeing access without interference, with fines to property owners who take matters into their own hands to disturb and discourage use. I am flatly asking you, will you do anything? Anyone care to comment?
I don't know. Access point at the end of Plaza and Pullman is
speak up a little?
Sure. And the contract has been awarded, so that was going to be done this summer. We don't want to wait. When the money's in place, the contract is in place. There's public access, meaning great water, and a home property that is actively used as public access. A couple other places along the way, I think at the end of every street, any fences put up illegally, we will address either ourselves or we can. Some of the issues have to be addressed by the state, we just don't have the authority. So putting the orders in place, fines, or anything else like that, we probably don't have the authority. As for parking, you know, most of the sites, we have limited parking, we're very narrow. Some of them have no parking, you can't get an emergency vehicle parking now. People can park on Lake Atkins and some of the other sites. But some of the buildings in the beach there, the amount of public, members of the public are coming down, it's increased exponentially, and it's actually pretty good.
Yeah.
And interestingly enough, I haven't had a single member of the public come up and call me or complain that they're never going to reach there.
Atkins is really horrible curbing there. I don't think that's allowed.
Where, when you say Atkins and curbing, where, I don't know.
The curbing by where there's supposed to be five spots for the public to go into park.
That's under construction.
It's under construction.
Yeah, but if you read the lettering, the...
That's not what the letter says. You're going to say that it has to be open during construction.
Yeah.
It's open during the construction of the project. They're doing the infrastructure. I have the DEP down there. Tammy Miller from Coastal Land Use Department was there and agreed. It's unsafe to have the public in during the construction of the site.
I understand what you're saying, and I know that you're trying, because I have heard people along the beach saying that, you know, you're trying.
Everything humanly possible.
What I'd like to see, though, is, like I asked once before...
Sprague, could you speak with the business administrator and perhaps the mayor a little later? We just want to...
Yes.
Thank you very much.